When I was a kid, I played baseball in the summers. I batted first in the lineup, standing at the plate, teeth gritting, bubblegum in my cheek, and evil in my eye. Mr. Haynes, our coach, was yelling, "Good eye, Kev, good eye." Now, "good eye, Kev" was actually code for "don't swing the bat, Kev," because I was tiny, not little, tiny, and no pitcher could throw a strike to me. I had no strike zone. I mean, the number on my shirt was tucked into my pants. So if I stood my ground, I walked to first every time. "Good eye, Kev, good eye." Oh, but man, I wanted to hit that ball so bad, because in the stands was my friend Cheryl. Cheryl was my best friend. She was teased a lot for running like a girl. That way of running like Marilyn Monroe, arms out to the side, hips swaying, knees together, feet shooting out in all directions. Cheryl's body was changing, so people, mostly young boys, focused on that and missed out on how cool and funny she was. "Good eye, Kev, attaboy, Kev," yells Mr. Haynes. Cheryl knew what I knew. Because of my arm, people made immediate assumptions about me. They called my arm withered or crippled or asked what happened. By the words they chose, I could tell whether they blamed God, my parents, the world, or themselves for my condition. And then with that information, I could get what I needed from them. It wasn't purposeful. It wasn't even conscious. It's just the way a kid works. The pitcher tried to get one over. "Good eye, Kev, attaboy." God, I wanted to swing that bat so bad. I decided the next pitch I'm going to swing no matter what. Even if I miss, it's only one strike. Cheryl and I had a carnival for muscular dystrophy. We sent away for the packet that told us how to have a backyard carnival for your neighborhood and raise money for this worthy cause. I couldn't wait to get the packet to tell us how to turn my ordinary backyard into the greatest show on earth. I would be Jimmy Stewart, the jocular clown, and Cheryl, the rope-spinning butterfly. But when the packet came, the games didn't seem fun at all. Some lame ring toss game, a totally unfunny clown kit. I mean, it was disappointing, like getting sea monkeys all over again. Cheryl said, "This won't make a dime." I asked, "Well, what do we do?" She said, "Give them what they want." So we made our own MD carnival. We hung up blankets in the backyard to create a big top and borrowed the mimeograph machine at school to make announcements of the upcoming spectacle. God, those announcements smell good. On show day, I put on swim fins and a snorkel, stripped to the waist, took off my arm brace, laid on the table, and became Dolphin Boy. I had to be constantly sponged with a saline solution to keep my skin moist like it was in my natural habitat, the ocean. To the wonder of the crowd, I performed math problems by means of honking a toy horn. I also pretended to have trouble breathing to add pathos to the situation and to show I'd rather be swimming free with my own kind. I was a hit. And then Cheryl did an exotic dance she called the Dance of the Seven Veils, revealing the mysteries of the Orient and bringing culture to the unwashed masses. Oh man, it brought the house down. Word got out, full houses every show. We could have run forever. We raked in the money for muscular dystrophy and had enough left over to pay the performers. "Good eye, Kev." But now the pitcher winds up and throws an obvious ball four. But this time I swing. I swing with all my might, and the ball rolls harmlessly toward the shortstop. I run toward first base. The shortstop picks up the ball and heaves it to first. The ball takes a short hop off the first baseman's leg and into the outfield. I scamper to second, and I don't even look. I am going to third. This may never happen again. Our whole team yells, "No!" I know Mr. Haynes is livid. The ball flies past me while I'm not even halfway to third, but it sails way over the third baseman's head. I round third for home. I hit home plate, and who is running toward me? Not Mr. Haynes. Oh no, we'll have a talk later. No, it's Cheryl, running like a girl.